Pappu. I've got all these dishes, but I want to taste some more Pappu. It's as good as that. What's really interesting here is that every single dish, every single condiment here has its own flavor, has its own special touch.
We are in the Ameerpet area of Hyderabad and we are here to lunch at what is an iconic eatery here. And this one is Shri Kakatiya Deluxe Mess. Now, Shri Kakatiya Deluxe Mess has a reputation that goes far and wide in this city. Talk to locals about where to have the best vegetarian meal and chances are the answer will be Shri Kakatiya Deluxe Mess. And alongside the vegetarian meal, they also serve up some delicious non-vegetarian sides. So let's go in and taste some Andhra style bhojanam. So I'm here with Mr. Varun Karthik, who is the third generation of Shri Kakatiya Deluxe Mess. So what makes it so popular?
Vegetarian meals is famous. Along with that, two of the curries are also famous too. Like one is mutton fry and other one is chicken.
Okay.
So we've been maintaining that quality and that quantity.
Quality and quantity?
Yes.
So you believe in feeding your customers?
Yes, with quality food.
And in quantity?
Yes.
Alright, and how old is Shri Kakatiya?
It's 26 to 27 either.
Okay, and who started it?
So my father started it. Started on 1992, September 9th.
Okay.
Yeah, it started here.
So every day do you have a lunch menu that keeps changing?
Yeah, we are the vegetarian dishes.
Ah, brinjal curry.
Yeah, this is cabbage fry and this is dal, tomato dal.
Tomato pappu.
Yeah, we keep on changing alternatives. If we keep tomato dal in the lunch, we keep palak dal in the for dinner.
So the sambar and the rasam has also just come out.
This is our special sambar.
What is the vegetable in this?
You'll find drumsticks, carrot, tomato, onion.
Ah, so this is the mixed vegetable sambar. So why is it called a mess?
Initially we started with meals, only meals and some curries.
Okay.
That's why it's called as mess and it's very long back, right?
That's interesting. I was asking him why it's called a mess and he said when we began, it was probably twice the size of this small area here and they began serving meals and a few curries and that's why they called it a mess. But today, of course, it's grown into this large space, but beyond the space, I think the reputation of Shri Kakatiya Deluxe Mess is much, much bigger than even the space that it has is today. Let's go into the kitchen.
This is the basic kitchen. The main kitchen is down. There's one, the rice cooking area.
So everything is cooked for the day. All this is rice. So you know that people here love their rice. So there are four big vessels of rice and will you be cooking constantly? Yeah?
Prawn.
Oh, this is a prawn, okay.
This one is mutton fry, sir.
Mutton fry. This is a special.
This one is chicken curry.
Chicken curry, oh this looks so good. And this is the Kakatiya chicken fry. So this restaurant is so popular that they have a dine-in section and there's a takeaway section. So in the dine-in section, because of the number of people that come through the doors here, so they have the meals and then they have about four other side dishes, non-vegetarian dishes that they serve on a daily basis. And of course, I'm told your omelettes even are very popular. I can see all those eggs there and I know that they cook a lot of omelettes. And I think that's interesting because, you know, you've got only that limited number of dishes that you're looking forward to savour. Of course, if you're looking at doing a takeaway, they have more dishes that one can order from. But today we are here to experience, to taste at the dine-in. So one meals, one chicken curry, one chicken fry, and give me one mutton fry and prawns fry. We'll also taste the omelette. We've delayed our trip getting out of Hyderabad just for this one meal and I'm looking forward to this. So there you go, the meal has begun. It's very quick. You sit on the table and they immediately put a tray in front of you. Of course, you've got all your chutneys here. So this is the eggplant chutney, I'm told. You know, just looking at all of this, my mouth is watering. And then this is the thokku or the pickle here. This, I'm told, is a carrot and capsicum thokku and some mango thokku. So we've got all the dishes that we ordered for right here. Of course, I have my vegetarian thali here, which is the centerpiece of a meal here at Kakatiya. So on my thali, I have the tomato pappu, I have the cabbage pakora, I have the eggplant and dry pea vegetable, I have some rice, papad, and then there's a sweet that you can actually make a start with. This is a semolina sweet, and not to forget the perugu, the thick curd. And in the sides, this is the mutton fry, this is the prawn fry, and then of course I have the chicken curry here, and this is the mutton curry. And not to forget an omelette, which I'm told is also very popular here at Sri Kakatiya. But I'm going to begin first with the rice, and I'm going to begin not just with the rice, but I'm going to begin with that podi first that I see here. If you look at this podi, you know, it's very different from the podis that I'm typically used to seeing. I can see a lot more of the ingredients here. So I can see the curry leaf, I can see the garlic, I can see the lentils that have been powdered into it, and of course all the spices. So the way to begin your meal here at Kakatiya Deluxe Mess is to take some of this podi. I hope it's not too spicy. Put it on your rice and ladle some ghee onto that rice. Of course, onto the rest of the rice as well. Ghee makes everything taste really good. Even as I'm mixing this, my mouth is watering. All the juices are flowing. And begin with this mouthful. You can taste that lush butteriness of the ghee first, and then you taste the podi. And the good thing about this podi is that it has bite. So you can taste a bit of the curry leaf, you can taste a bit of the spice, you get a bit of the chili heat, you get the crunch of some of the lentils. It's a podi that certainly makes you notice what's gone into it. It's also got that slight warmth at the back of your throat that I can now sense. It's a very different podi from any podi that I've tasted thus far. Typically, when I taste podis, they're all very smooth, they're almost powder-like. But this podi here, you can see all the ingredients. You can taste some of that garlic too. The perfect start to a meal here. I'm going to begin with the vegetarian dishes first. Go for some of that pappu. That pappu is nice and thick and creamy, that tomato pappu or the dal. I think what differentiates a regular dal from a pappu is the thickness of the pappu. There's some curry leaves as well. It's the sort of pappu that you would get in a typical Andhra home where the lady of the house is a great cook. It's simple in its flavors, yet is a sort that leaves you satisfied. Taste some of that cabbage fritter now. Never had a cabbage fritter, cabbage pakoda. I thought it was cauliflower first, but it's cabbage. Makes it a great crunchy sort of a interlude as you're tasting your meal. Some more pappu. The pappu is seriously good. And I'm told this tomato pappu is the favorite of customers here, and I can understand why. In fact, I'm going to ask him for some more pappu. I've got all these dishes, but I want to taste some more pappu. It's as good as that. Let's taste that eggplant and the dry peas, the vankaya. Oh, this is delicious. You know, this vegetable by itself is also delicious. I'm not a big vankaya or eggplant fan, but if I'm eating a vankaya dish, that means it's seriously good. It's got this delicious velvety texture, intense in its flavor. The flavor that perhaps comes from some onions, some chilies that go into it. There's that turmeric that goes into the dish as well. Just that rice and that vankaya with the dried peas. Such a happy bite. Let's go back for some more of the pappu. You know, when this meal, when they placed all this in front of me, I was seriously eyeing all the non-veg dishes. I said, I'll very quickly finish this and go for the non-veg. But this vegetarian thali is so seriously good that I don't mind lingering and spending some more time on this vegetarian thali. But this pappu is delicious. It's got that, of course, the tomato,
you know, gives it that slightly tart edge. And you taste that, you know, the comforting flavor that comes from lentils. You know, there's nothing as comforting as a good lentil dish. And this pappu is a great example of that. That tomato in this tomato pappu just gives it that slight edge of sourness, which is what's so nice about this particular preparation. Some papad. This is supposed to be an eggplant chutney. I've never really tasted an eggplant in a chutney before. It's got the rice, got those mustard seeds that I can definitely taste. So it gives it that slightly deep flavor. So this chutney also has cucumber in it, which gives it that nice refreshing sort of a crunch. I'm to taste some of the thokku, and I'm beginning with the carrot thokku. That sesame oil, that flavor, wow. You know, the spices here are very well-rounded, I must say. Be it in the vegetables or even in the thokku, even in the pickles, the spices are very well-rounded. It doesn't have that sharp chili spike that you would typically expect of an Andhra meal. No, no, none of that. The flavors here are very well-rounded and beautifully balanced. I think I'll taste the last bite of the tomato pappu before I go for the non-vegetarian dishes. Rice, pappu, papad. Next, I'm going to go for the prawns. And these are those tiny shrimps, the freshwater shrimps, the fresh shrimps. None of that frozen stuff. The tinier the prawn, the greater is the flavor, the deeper is the flavor. But that's really what I'm expecting to taste. It's in this semi-dry sort of a preparation. That masala in this is a deep roasted masala. So it's got the onions, it's got some coconut in it as well. And the curry leaf that gives it that beautiful, deeply roasted sort of a flavor. And the prawns are cooked just right. With prawns, especially when they're small, it's very easy to overcook them. And if you overcook them, it tends to be rubbery. But this prawn is cooked just right. Take some of that curry leaf, taste it with that prawn. So good. I think next we're going to taste the chicken fry. You know, when I'm tasting food, I like to taste seafood first, then chicken, then mutton or meat in the ascending order of flavor. So let's taste some of this chicken fry. The masala here for the chicken fry is very different from the masala that I see in the prawn fry. You can see the colors here. This is a darker roasted masala. This is a lighter roasted masala for the chicken. As I am shooting this, I can hear the whistle of the pressure cooker go. So, you know, when we came in, we were the only people around. But slowly but surely, the restaurant is beginning to fill up. You can see people all around now. Okay, let's go for the chicken fry. It's tiny bits of chicken, so I think it's a sort of dish that makes it easier to share. You can taste that masala right away. This chicken has absorbed all that goodness of that masala. Oh, this is so good. You know, when you look at this preparation, you also see some of that oil, that residual oil that is perhaps what the masala was first cooked in before the chicken was added. That again is such a delicious flavor because it's got the oil, so you've got that, the texture, the lush texture of that oil, the fat of the oil, which has absorbed all that masala. So that oil in itself is so delicious, which is coating that chicken so beautifully well, resulting in that masala. So you've got the oil, you've got the spices that have infused into that oil and spices are now what's coating the chicken, resulting in that very flavorful bite. And that chicken is cooked just perfectly. I'm told another popular side dish here is the omelette. I almost forgot about it. The omelette is one of those dishes. So you take an egg, cook it in some form. It just makes your meal, the non-vegetarian quotient of your meal, go that much more longer. And I think that's what the omelette here is. Simple. You got the onions. You got the spicy heat of the pachi mirchi, the green chili. And it's a well-roasted sort of an omelette. Those are the sort of flavors that you taste. Simply prepared, but very tasty. So next, I'm going to taste this chicken curry. You know, when you look at this chicken curry, this is Pretty much it looks like a homestyle chicken curry. The sort of chicken curry that you would get if you went to a Andhra home, and that's what this looks like. It's got this masala, and I'm told that all the spices here are hand ground. So they grind their own spices, they make their own masalas, which results, I guess, in their own unique taste. And I'm going to taste this with the rice. You know, this masala is an assertive masala. So when you taste it, it immediately makes its presence felt on your palate. It's that sort of slightly rough aggression that you taste on your palate. You know, that's the sort of dish that you taste. So when you taste a dish and that dish immediately takes hold of your palate, that's the sort of chicken curry that this is. Home style sort of a chicken curry with that aggression of the spices. It's not hot, mind you, but it's just that you can taste the spices come alive on your palate. That's really what this chicken curry is all about. This is a delicious chicken curry. Some hot rice to welcome the mutton fry here, which is another very popular dish. You can see that the masala in this is deeply roasted, resulting in that color. You can see the oils that have perhaps all the spices infused in them. You know, this is exactly the sort of meat piece that I love. It's got the meat, but it's also got the fat that's encasing the meat. You need that fat to convey the flavors of the meat. So this has that onion masala, so the onions are roasted well. So you have that slight, mild sweetness of the onion and the spices. That's the dominant flavor alongside the meat in this mutton pepper fry. I'm going to taste this meat now with the rice. What I'm beginning to appreciate here is the butchery skills, is the way in which this meat has been cut. So it's tiny pieces, but when you're cooking tiny pieces, they tend to dry out. But here, most of the meat is encased in a thin sheath of fat. And that's what retains, that's what allows these tiny pieces, these tiny morsels of the mutton to retain its juiciness and convey all those flavors. You know, the texture of the meat, it's almost velvety when you taste it in your mouth. This is such a delicious dish. You can taste that masala. You can taste some of that fenugreek that's gone into this masala. So good. What's really interesting here is that every single dish, every single condiment here has its own flavor, has its own special touch. You know, I've tasted all these dishes, and to me, each one of them stood out. Each one of them was special. Typically, when you go into a restaurant, you will find a couple of dishes that you like very much, some dishes that you don't like as much. But out here at Kakatiya Mess, they only do a few dishes, but those dishes, they do them supremely well. Go for some of that pappu. Get a little bit of the prawns on my plate, and perhaps also some of that mutton, just to mix and match the dishes, the flavors here. As we come to the close of our meal here, it's time to taste the rice with the sambar and the rasam. I'm going to make three mounds, first for the sambar. It's hot. When you're served hot food, you actually taste the food even before you eat it, because you feel the heat, you feel that comforting warmth of the food on your fingers. So there are all these vegetables that have gone to make this nourishing sambar. What you also taste is a hint of sweetness that comes perhaps from some jaggery that has gone into the sambar too. You know, the sambar in its consistency is not too thick, neither is it too watery. But it's just a sort of thing that you need to, as you come closer to the end of your meal here at Kakatiya. I'm near sated now. Such a happy meal, but I still have to taste the rasam. The color of this rasam is almost a bright yellow. I think there's a fair amount of turmeric that goes into this rasam. none of that fiery, spicy reputation that Andhra cuisine unfortunately seems to have. This rasam is flavorful. It has a gentle heat that perhaps comes from some pepper that's gone into it and that slight tartness of the tomato. You know, I'm really quite full and I'm groaning my way to the finish line at this tasting here. But sometimes you taste food that's so delicious that you just forget whatever boundaries you may have set for yourself in terms of how much you should be eating. That's the sort of food that I'm tasting here. And this, I think, is the appropriate time to proceed to the perugu annam. This perugu is so thick, it refuses to come out. I think I need a spoon for this. This is a thick perugu. Just a sort of close to your meal here. Simple, wholesome, deliciously thick curd. Almost forgot the sweet here. So the sweet here is a simple affair. It's a semolina pudding or a halwa or a sheera with some tutti frutti. Had we left without shooting an episode of Gourmet on the Road at Kakatiya Mess? Okay, we've got something more. Double ka meetha. Or a bread pudding. Bread that is cooked, soaked actually in a syrup flavored with sweet spices. Of course, they also have some tutti frutti here. So I think they like the tutti frutti here when it comes to desserts. That is rich. You can taste the richness in that sweet. And I think I'm going to reach for this glass of buttermilk here. Because after a meal like this, that's what you need. You need the soothing properties of a buttermilk to help settle your tummy. When you're in Hyderabad next, make sure you come to Sri Kakatiya Deluxe Mess to savor that deliciously nourishing, wholesome thali along with some of the other equally satisfying homestyle preparations. Better still, I think this is one of those restaurants that you can make a trip to Hyderabad just for. That's how wonderful a meal here at Sri Kakatiya Deluxe Mess is. So until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
At Food Lovers TV, my team and I work hard to produce engaging food and travel videos. If you like our work, do check out our Patreon page where you can pledge a nominal sum in lieu of special privileges like behind the scenes footage, early video release, exclusive Q&As, merch and much more. For more info, check out the link in the description below. Also, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe, share, like and leave a comment here. Happy eating!